So today I am going to explain about the topic is measurement of pressure. So this is the fluid mechanics subject in the first unit. So many topics are over, and next topic is measurement of pressure. So basically, before going to explain about the measurement of pressure, so what is the use of, what is the importance of pressure, where you can use the pressure, what are the different equipments, what are the different machineries, what are the parts will be there in the like measurement of pressure. Okay, so what is pressure? So basically, when you apply the force on anything, then you can say it as a pressure. Here see the pressure is equal to force per area. So pressure is equal to force per area. So suppose in the liquid, liquid is flowing in a pipeline, then you have to find out the pressure in a liquid. So suppose this is the pipeline. So if you want to find out the pressure in the pipeline, then you can go for that. So these are the machineries parts, or these are the different equipments are used to find out the pressure. So measurement of pressure. So measurement of pressure is basically two types. So first one is manometers and second one is mechanical gauges. So coming to manometers. So manometer is a device which you use to find out the pressure in a of a fluid, pressure of a fluid in a liquid. And mechanical gauges like pressure gauges, vacuum gauges, these are the mechanical gauges. And again, manometers can be classified into two types: simple manometers and differential manometers. And again, simple manometers can be classified into three types: piezometer, U-tube manometer, single column manometer. And again, differential manometer classified into again two types: U-tube differential manometers and U-tube inverted differential manometer. So whatever it may be, along these all machinery equipment, there is a common thing is there is one liquid will be there in the U-tube manometer, that is mercury. So basically, why you are using mercury in the U-tube manometer? So U-tube manometer is nothing but the shape of the U-tube is like that. So this is the U-tube, and so this is the pipeline, and you are connected these U-tube here, and the liquid comes to these points, and here the U-tube is filled with mercury. So this is the mercury level, and this is the water liquid. The liquid flows like this, and here when you apply pressure, the water comes here, touches the surface of the mercury. When water touches the mercury level, then there is an increase in the mercury height. So that height is equal to P is equal to rho g h. So this is the height h, you can find out the rho is the density of water, g is the gravity, and h is the height of the liquid, and you can get the pressure in Newton per meter square. So this is the pressure you are going to find out here. And one more thing, why are you using particularly mercury in the U-tube manometer? Because mercury have the highest density among all the liquids. And suppose the water density is 1000 kg per meter cube. And whereas the mercury density is 13600 kg per meter cube. So because you are using particularly mercury in the liquid. And one more thing, these mercury will not touches the tube walls. Here the tube walls, and that is not touches to the. And one more thing, why are using liquid in that one? Simply when you give a simple pressure on the liquid, and the response of the mercury is very high. So because that is the reason we are going to use the mercury in the U-tube manometer. And coming to simple manometer, what is simple manometer? Let us take a glass. Suppose this is imagine that this is the glass. So this is the height of the liquid. When you take the height of the liquid h and substitute in that formula, here you can get the pressure in the beaker or vessel or glass, whatever it may be. So like that you can find out the pressure. So that is the simple manometer. And again, simple manometer can be classified into piezometer, U-tube manometer, single column manometer. And again, differential manometer, U-tube differential manometer, and U-tube inverted differential manometer. So this is the overall view of the measurement of pressure of a flowing liquid in the pipeline by using the mercury or by using the manometer. Thank you.